So the first thing we're going to do, so depending how you want to handle the headers, you may or not do something there, but for now what I'm going to do is I'm going to just highlight the actual data, put it into a table. So once we've got into table, I can see what I need. I'm going to go to data from table range. So I've now put all that in. You can see here that this has decided maybe those are the headers. And that's clearly not what I want. So don't forget, one of the options you have, if I go here where it says use first row as header, I can actually say use headers as first row. So when I click on it, you'll see it drops it down. So we're now back to a position of seeing two records for each record. What I do know is I want everything to move down. So let's see, I'm going to go here, I'm going to say transform, I'm going to say fill down. Doesn't seem to have done it, but for those it's fine. What we're interested in is the date must come down. So I'm going to say fill down. So that seems to have done what we've needed. This one seems to repeat itself anyway. So all this information now seems to be correct. What we now want to do is we know we need to remove any row that has this word Tim in it. So let's just scroll down. That looks about right. So I'm going to say I don't want to see Tim. I only want to see the ones that are blank. Switch off Tim. So okay, what we should now have is our data with both lines being combined into one. If we're happy with that, close and load, and you'll see we've gone from this. So for example, the first one, so what we wanted to see was 1165, the date and that bit of information. 1165, I've got a date, and the various bits of information are now in the same row.